I'm gonna hate this, so it just looks like you're working.
Yeah.
I'll get some B-roll. Unless you're actually working, then you're good to go.
Well, the problem with this one, it's not stabilized. You see, come on.
Just kinda bangs around in there.
Just see. Oh, that's not good. Now.
I'll edit that part out.
See how that shakes?
Yeah, like the whole camera shakes around in there.
Yeah.
It is.
These motors here and here. Stabilizer motors. They're actually pancake motors. See? They
yeah.
need to be recentered. Because once you take them off there, sits just a little bit out of sync. See, but if you push them a little bit back into sync, it stops. But.
So how hard is that to put all back in sync?
Not bad at all. These are pot trims up in here.
Alright.
Easy adjustments. Just actually quite easy to fix. You just put them on an ohm meter or a voltmeter. Conversely, I'll hook it up in here, make the fine adjustments to recenter. Because what happens is this has a point of reference of 6 volts either way. So look at the camera. See how this swings either direction?
Mm-hmm.
The processor reads it as plus 6 volts, minus 6 volts, and zero is this stationary position. So it needs to sit at zero to be balanced. Just like there's a motor up in here for a side motor. Does it the same way, plus 6 minus volts.
But the side motor's good.
Yeah. So what the camera does ultimately, when it sits stabilized, dealing off the subject of the gyro, but when it sits stabilized, the whole camera sits at a zero position. Anytime there's a swing in any direction, it puts out voltages, plus and minus directional degrees. And what happens is, when it has a swing like that, the main processor drives these boards right here, all the motor driver boards. They control your roll, your inner and outer azimuth, your outer elevation, and your outer azimuth, which is located all the way up in here. This is in the gear head. Here's the motor for that.
Mm-hmm.
Big rotary gear underneath. So what happens is anytime this center ring falls out of position, drives the motor circuitry board to put it back into zero state position.
Yeah.
So all 5 of these motors are in sync. You know, the roll motor, in case you're turning, it'll just roll back and forth. And this main box lens through the 29-pin connector in the back. But everything is set in the manual position. Hence, that's why you have operation from this control unit here. But, I mean, technically, you could put the system on auto.